It began the day America decided to put a man into space, created Project Mercury to get him there, and safely back. Project Mercury, America's all ahead, all at once, initial step in manned space exploration. October 1958, Project Mercury went to work. Assembled a team of scientists, engineers, and technicians to manage America's manned spaceflight programs, to select and train the men who would be the free world's first space pilots, the seven Mercury astronauts. American industry went to work too. January 1959, McDonnell Aircraft was chosen to produce the Mercury spacecraft. To lift it into orbit, Project Mercury selected the Atlas rocket. There were dozens of flight tests. The operation of spacecraft and booster systems in actual flight. And when there were difficulties, no one tried to hide them. Then, when the tests indicated that everything was ready, man was added. May 5, 1961. Astronaut Alan B. Shepard became the free world's first space pilot.
All right, lift off and the clock
had indeed started. Free man was on his way into space. First with Redstone-powered ballistic flights downrange. Shepard in Freedom 7. And on July 25, 1961, astronaut Virgil Gus Grissom in Liberty Bell 7. These Redstone flights paved the way for the Atlas-boosted orbital missions. November 29, 1961. Mercury Atlas flight test number 5. A chimpanzee named Enos. Was orbited. Tracked. And recovered unharmed, confirming that the Mercury spacecraft could sustain life in orbit. 1 hour after Enos was recovered, Project Mercury named astronaut John Glenn to pilot America's first manned orbital flight. February 20, 1962, a day free men will never forget.
Ahmed,
go.
ECS,
go.
Sequence,
go.
Electrical,
go.
ASCS,
go.
RCS,
go.
Stop,
go.
CM,
go.
CO,
CO, go.
Flight,
go.
Sony,
go.
And the final moments. T-minus 30 seconds and counting.
Turning around, and I could see the booster during turnaround just a couple of hundred yards behind.
Roger. Understand go for at least 7 orbits.
Astronaut John Glenn is in orbit, 100 miles above the Atlantic. 17,545 miles an hour, 5 miles a second. 22 minutes after liftoff, lunchtime in space, over Kano, Nigeria. The flight continues. Orbit number 2, around the world in 88 minutes. Number 3, out in the Atlantic, the recovery forces are ready. The Atlantic. Columbus crossed it in 3 months. Lindbergh in 33 and a half hours. John Glenn in 14 minutes. For the third time, John Glenn sees the sun rise out of the trackless Pacific. Then it is time to fire the retro rockets that will slow the spacecraft and bring it back to Earth. John Glenn and Friendship 7 return to Earth. Four hours and 56 minutes in space as the representative of all the members of the Mercury team, all the people of America, and all men who treasure freedom everywhere.